We are here at the base of the Giants Ridge Mountain today. It's Wednesday, the 1st of December, and we're joined by Sherry Swanson and Kurt Samuelson, two of our snowmakers. And if you've watched any of our videos, you've met these two snowmakers before. Now, Kurt, this snow gun right here, I'm gonna back up a little bit, is hooked up to the back of this Tucker, and that you and Sherry are taking this snow gun where?
Well, we're going to take it to the drain on line 8 that's back past chairlift 5 on cat tracks there.
Okay, because snowmaking has been shut down this week, and then will you start up again today?
We're planning on it right afternoon, probably guessing around 1 o'clock or so.
Okay, and I'm going to go around here if I can. I'm going to show the hose here, this big green hose, and you'll hook this up to a water hydrant that's out on the mountain?
Yes.
Okay, and then what about what you were telling me earlier about how you decide how the guns are tilted? So, depending on weather.
This thing here will control that. Now, if we have warmer temperatures, we're gonna want to get the water a little higher in the sky so it has more time to freeze on the way down.
Okay.
So we'll have it pointed up like that.
Okay.
Just crank it the other way, and we can kind of control where the snow goes a little bit better when we have it down. So when it gets colder, like tonight, the guys on night shift will probably want to lower them a little bit.
Okay, and I imagine you get better control when it's colder of how you can make snow in what areas?
Yeah, that, and then the wind has a lot to do with it too. I mean, it's going to blow wherever, and we just have to position the guns so that they're not hitting the trees and then all the snow is landing on the run.
Okay, and then what about these valves here that you were showing me earlier? These three valves, can you tell us about these?
Right, well, they're color-coded. Green is the smallest that controls the smaller nozzles on the gun.
Okay.
And when it's snowmaking weather, we'll turn on the green first. It gets a little bit colder, then
okay.
We'll turn on the blue, and then the red. And once these are all open, then we've got maximum snow production from this gun.
Okay, so tonight if it gets really cold, this gun will be pointed more straight out, not up like it is right now, correct?
Yes, somewhat.
Okay, and then if it's really cold again tonight, all three of these valves will be open.
Yes, they will.
Okay, and what about this past weekend when we opened, for example, on the Sarajevo run, the guns were removed, but then will you make snow again on Sarajevo?
We're probably gonna end up taking a couple of guns back there, but that'll generally happen after we've completed all the runs here, and then we'll go back and we'll patch up areas where we think we might need a little bit more snow, places where it might wear thin. Say springtime comes around and you have those areas that the dirt kind of shows up in. So we'll want to get snow, especially in those areas.
Okay, so during the month of December, just because we open up a run to the public doesn't mean that all the snowmaking is done. You
no.
Keep tending to those runs.
Yes, we do.
Okay, and what about the snow tubing park? How is that coming along?
It's coming along. We had moved a gun over to Hydrant 11 on Cortina there. That's right by the side of where it's going to be just today, and we're going to be firing that one up this afternoon too.
Okay, so you'll be making snow for the first time for the tubing park then?
Yes.
Okay, that is great news. I bet a lot of people will be excited to hear that.
Oh yeah.
Okay, definitely. So you're going to take this gun and go place it out on near North Face, you said?
Yes.
Okay. All right, well, thanks for taking a few minutes, stopping by and giving us an update, and let's just all hope for really cold weather tonight.
Yes. Thank you, Shannon.
Fingers crossed. Thank you.